Hi, hello and welcome to Techguru.civil. In this STAAD.Pro e-learning series, today we are going to discuss about the continuous beam problem number 5. Particularly this problem has different I coefficient in all the members and support B and C is going to sink by 8 mm and 3 mm respectively. Here the flexural rigidity EI value is given. Now we are going to analyze this problem by using STAAD.Pro Connect Edition. Here our task is to analyze this continuous beam to determine the support reaction. Then we need to do the equilibrium check. Finally, we are going to draw shear force diagram, bending moment diagram and elastic curve. Not only that, we are going to cross verify the and calculated results with the STAAD.Pro analysis results. In the present problem, the units are in kilonewton and meter. Now, let's get started with the software STAAD.Pro Connect Edition. To create a new file, click on the new, then provide the model information. File name, I am going to give it as problem 5. Then select the location, then select the type of the model, let it be analytical, then unit, select the metric. Then provide the job information, then click on create. Initially, we need to take care of two things. One is the UCS. Now it is in isometric view. To change that one, go to the view and click on the front view. You can observe the UCS here. Then come back to geometry. And the second thing is input units. Click on the input units, go to the metric, select meter and kilonewton, click apply. Now we are going to create the geometry by using coordinate system. Now click on the coordinate, provide the coordinates, let the initial coordinate be 0, 0. Then second coordinate is 6, 0. Then third one is 6 plus 8, that is 14, 0. Then 14 plus 6, that is 20, 0. Now click on the graphical window, click on add beam, then connect the beam from one node to the another node. Now once the geometry is over, next go to the properties panel. Since EI value is given, we need to select the material first. Go to the materials, click on create. Now from the drop down menu, select concrete and rename it. In order to access the properties, I'm going to give it as 01. Now here EI value is given as 2 into 10 power 4 kilonewton meter square. Now let us assume that E will be 2 into 10 power 4 and I will be 1. So I'm going to provide here E value as 2 into 10 power 4. So let's give that one 2 into 10 power 4, that is E to the power of plus 0.4. Now click on OK. Next, once we done that one, come back to the properties, then go to the define. In order to define the prismatic property, go to the general. Let's take the area as 0.5 meter square, then IX, I let it be 1. Since we have different I coefficient, I'm going to create one first for the first member. Then material, I'm going to take it as concrete 01, which we defined with E value. Then click on add. Then for the second member, I coefficient is 1.5. Let's keep the AX area same. Then we are going to change the I coefficient value. For the second member, it is 1.5. Then material concrete 01, click add. Then for the third member, coefficient is 2, change it. Then click on add, close. Now in order to highlight the nodes, press shift K on your keyboard. Then select the first property with I coefficient 1. Select use cursor to assign, click on assign, click on the first member. Then second property with I coefficient 1.5. click on the second member. Then third property with I coefficient 2, click on the third member. Now go to the materials. The material has been already assigned. Then specification, no need. Then go to the supports, click on create. Here we need to create a roller support as well as fixed support. In order to create roller support, we are going to make use of fixed butt or enforced butt. The only difference is that if we have the displacement at the nodes, then we are going to make use of enforced butt option to create the supports. If you don't have any displacement, then we can make use of fixed butt option. At A, we don't have any displacement, so go to the fixed butt option. Then for roller support, one reaction, that is in Y direction. So check out all other things except FY. Then click on add. Then again click on create. At B and C, the support is sinking, so go to the enforced butt option. Then at the B and C, we have roller support, nothing but one reaction, that is FY. Since we need releases, check out all other things except FY. Click on add, then click on create, then select fixed, click add, then select the support, use cursor to assign, assign, then click on the node A. This is the support, roller support without any displacement. Then select the roller support with the displacement and assign it to the node B and C. Then select the fixed support, click on the node D. Then go to the loading option, load case details, click on add and change the title to live load. Click add, close, select the live load case, click on add. Since we have support displacement or support syncing, go to the nodal load. There we have the option support displacement, click on it. Then here support displacement is 8 mm and 3 mm in the downward direction. So click on minus sign to indicate the downward direction. Then at B we have 8 mm, but we need it here in terms of meters. So it is converted, divided by 1000, it becomes 0.008 meters in Y direction. Then click on add. Then again support displacement of 3 mm in the downward direction at C. So change it to 0.003. Then Y direction, click on add. Then we have the member load off. Go to the member load. On BC, we have UDL, uniform force, of intensity 10 in the downward direction, that is minus 10. Since it is acting over the entire length of the member, no need to provide the distance. Select GY, click add, then close it. Now select support displacement of 8 mm, then use cursor to assign, assign, and click on the second node, that is B point. Then support displacement of 3 mm, click on the third node, that is C point. Then UDL, click on the second member. Now once it is over, go to the analysis, analysis commands, perform analysis, select no print option, click add, close. First analysis commands, define commands, select analysis results, add, close. Then click on run analysis, click save. We got 0 error, 1 warning and 1 note. Then go to the view output file, click on done. Then maximize the window, close this pop-up box, double click on this analysis result. We got joint displacement, support reaction and member end forces. We can cross verify these results with the AND calculation results provided. By comparing these two, we found that these two results are matching, and we can also do the equilibrium check, that is at the intermediate joint sum of the moment should be 0, like here minus 15 plus 15, then minus 49 plus 49, it will become 0. Then at the last joint, if you have simple roller or hinged support, then at that point the moment should be zero. At A, that is nothing but year, we have roller support, therefore the moment will be zero. From this we can conclude that the equilibrium check has been done. After this confirmation, we will move on to the further step, that is post-processing. Now close this window, click on the workflow, then click on post-processing, select the load, click on apply, click OK. Now maximize the window, turn up the displacement result. Now click on the file, click on settings, display option. In the diagrams, in order to increase the point size, we need to do some changes here. Now click on the node label, click on the point and change the point size to 12 from 8. Initially it will be 8. Now click on OK. Like that, for beam label also, then load label, then annotation and dimension. Click OK. Once we're done with this one, then zoom it, then click on the view loading diagram, then click on scale option, beside that labels. Under loading display option, click on loading values, click on apply, click OK. Then in order to display the dimensions, go to the utilities tab. In that beams tool option, click on dimension beams, click on display, click close, then right click, then click on the take picture. Give the ID as load diagram LD, then caption will be load diagram. Click OK. Then click on the reaction, maximize, then click on annotate, reactions. Since it is 2D analysis, we need global X, global Y and global RZ, and tick all other things. In order to see these results graphically instead of text, click on the show lines and give the scale as around 50. We can change it afterwards. Click on annotate. Then I will change this one. Okay. I will change it to around 25. Then this one to around 25. Okay. Click close. Now we got the support reactions graphically. Once you got the value, then right click, first zoom into the window, then right click, then click on take picture, give the ID as SR, then caption, let it be support reaction. Then click OK. Then go to the beam results, maximize, turn up the MZ, that is bending. Now activate shear FY, then zoom it. Then by holding the control button on your keyboard, move your mouse wheel in the forward direction to increase the drawing. Next, you can go to the annotate option to bring up the result. Then beam results, click on shear at the ends, then bending at the ends, then displacement for maximum resultant, click on annotate, click close. Once we got the values, then right click, click on take picture, give the ID as SFD, then caption as shear force diagram. Then click OK. Then turn off that result. Click on MZ for bending moment diagram. Then by holding the control button, move your mouse wheel in the forward direction. Then adjust it to fit this diagram into the window by zooming in or zooming out. Then right click. Click on take picture. Give the ID as BMD. Then caption will be bending moment diagram. Then click on OK. Then turn up that bending result. Click on the displacement for elastic curve. Then by holding the control button, move your mouse wheel in the forward direction. Now right click, click on take picture, give the ID as this, then caption will be ID, I will give it as EC, then caption let it be elastic curve. In the bracket we can write it as displacement. Click on OK. Now once we're done with all these things, click on the reports, then go to the option, untick header and footer option, come back to items. The job info has been already selected. Then go to the available option, in that drop down menu select output and search for the reactions, select and click on the forward button to select that one. Then in that only search for the beam end forces. Now click on the single forward button. Now in the available option click on the pictures. In order to select all the things, click on the double forward arrow button. Now we need to rearrange these things according to the given format. First job info, then load diagram. In order to make it upward or downward, we can make use of these two buttons, up or down. Okay, job info, load diagram, then support reaction table, then we need support reaction diagram, then beam end forces, then SFD, BMD, elastic curve. Now it is perfect. Now click on OK. Since next page is not visible, just click on the print, click cancel. You are going to get it now. Click on the next page and check it out. Once it is OK, click on setup report, click on load or save, click on save as. I'm going to save it as problem 5. Then click OK. Just click OK. Then click on the print, select PDF printer, then click OK. Then where you want to save, save it. Now we got our report. It consisting of job information, then load diagram, then support reaction table, then we have support reaction diagram. It is the graphical representation of the reactions, then beam end forces where we are going to get shear forces and bending moments, then shear force diagram, then we got bending moment diagram, then we got displacement or the elastic curve. Now this concludes modeling, analysis and design of the continuous beam by using STAAD.Pro Connect Edition. Thanks for watching the video.